Hello everyone, welcome to Programming Knowledge. Welcome to yet another tutorial at Programming Knowledge. So in today's tutorial we are going to cover one problem, that is maximum sum subarray. I'll explain this problem. Suppose we have a test case array of this. We need to find the maximum subarray sum. So this is the maximum subarray sum is of 7. Okay, so let me tell you one thing. Here you can see this is the array minus 2, minus 3, 4, minus 1, minus 2, 1, 5, minus 3. This is the same. So we need to find the subarray which has the maximum sum. So we can first solve the solution using brute force. Define brute force. And I have an array A. I have the length of the array N. And now what I can do, I can generate all the subarrays. I write a comment. A brute force solution would do what it will do, generate all the subarrays and then generate all the subarrays, check which subarray has the max sum. So this is the brute force solution, generate all the subarrays and then check which subarray has the max sum. And then we can return, then we can reach to our answer. So this is a brute force solution. Let's solve using the brute force solution. So first, subarrays is equal to this. This will contain all the subarrays. Now for I in range n plus 1, then for j in range I plus 1 comma n plus 1, then subarray is equal to a of I to the j, and then subarrays dot append subarray. And then what we can do, we can print subarrays. So we can print, and now we can call our test case, brute force of the test case. So let's run our program. So here you can see I have all the subarrays for this particular array. So here you can see this is a subarray, this is a subarray, this is a subarray. Now what we can do, we can find the subarray with the maximum sum. So let us do one thing. Max sum is equal to float of minus infinity. And what we can do, you can comment this, because we are not I'll run the test case. What I'll do, I'll just again print subarrays. And what I'll do, just a second, yes. So but what we are going to, we need to find the maximum sum of the subarrays. So what we can do, I can also comment this, and I'll do max sum is equal to maximum of max sum or sum of subarray. So this would solve our purpose, and then in the end I can type print max sum. So let me run the, yeah, here you get the answer 7. So this was the answer, this was the test case, the answer was 7. And what I'll do, I'll copy this, yes, and I'll put this on the top. Yeah, just a second, yes. So we got our answer, but time complexity of this solution is very large, since this time complexity is equal to n of q, because we use two loops for this n, and the sum function also takes n. So inside we do find n, so time complexity is n cube. But this same solution can be solved in the N approach. So for that, what we'll do, dynamic programming approach. So we'll use the DP approach, and for that case, what we can do, we can find the dynamic programming approach, define DP. For DP, we need to observe one thing, and what we need to observe that to find the maximum, I write in the comments, to find the max sum, what you can do, maximize maximize the max sum. So how we can do? How we can maximize the max sum? First, to maximize the max sum, we add positive integers only and neglect negative integers. Or since we are finding the sum, so you can also conclude the statement that we are finding the sum. To maximize the max sum, we add positive integers or sum or prefix sum only, and I'll move to the next line, and neglect the negative integers or negative sum or negative prefix sum. I just wanted to be very clear with this, so I made a very long statement using this. Now what you can do, since n is equal to len a, we would loop from for i, we would loop for I in range 1 comma n if a of I minus 1 is greater than 0, then a of I is equal to a of I plus a of I minus 1. Since this condition corresponds to the positive integers, either sum or prefix sum. So we would only be strict to our ideology that we add positive integers, sum or prefix sum only, and neglect negative integers, sum or prefix sum. Now we did maximize the maximum, we add positive integers, sum or prefix sum only, then return the max of array. So this would return the max of array, and that would meaning returning, by this we mean we are returning the max of integers, sum or prefix sum. So our answer is equal to max of a, and then print answer, and we can call our same solution for dp of s case. And when we return execute our program, so for this solution brute force and for the dp case, both the answer come out to be 7, and the answer was this sub array, that 4 comma minus 1 minus 2 1 comma 5. So I told you we try to maintain, like, we only add positive integers, sum or prefix sum only, but like, to be very honest, we only stick to this prefix sum only. Prefix sum is the only. We try to maintain, to maximize the sum, we add integers, sum or prefix sum only. Basically, I mean, here you can see, just to make you very clear that from the starting, we take positive integers and positive sum, positive integers, positive sum. But initially, what we do, we try to maintain positive prefix sum. So I repeat, positive prefix sum is our main motto. So we are doing the same. If a of I minus 1 is greater than 0, then maintain the positive prefix sum. So gradually we maintain that, and we achieve this using dynamic programming. So thank you guys for watching this tutorial. So we'll continue with more tutorials on DP as well. Thank you guys. Thank you so much.